to understand that one of the many reasons why a lot of families are in shambles, disarray, and have gone beyond repair is because of the foundations that either they or their partners laid. As Bible made us to understand that foundation is a very important part of every building. If a house must stand, its foundation must go 6 feet below the ground in order for it to avoid being blown off when the wind blows, when the storm comes. Now, let's talk about foundation. Why is it so necessary for a family to have a solid foundation? Let's go. Says, by our strength shall no man prevail, but we can do all things through Christ who strengthens us. Let's take our anchor scripture from the book of Matthew chapter 12 from verse number 25. Bible says, and Jesus says, a house divided against itself cannot stand. Any kingdom that is not in one accord with one another will be pulled down. Now, taking from this biblical expression, let's bring our understanding to the occurrence that is happening on earth today between countries versus countries. You will agree with me that any country that is not in agreement with one another will do everything to pull down the other country in order for this other one to stand out and be above the other ones. That is the exact thing that happens when marriage is not in agreement because of the foundation that we lay in there. Bible makes us to understand that any house that is divided against itself cannot stand. And any kingdom that is not in agreement with one another will fall. Why is it necessary for us to avoid every form of division in our homes? It is necessary because it prevents us from falling and it prevents us from being divided. Now, what are these occurrences that when it comes or when it steps into our family, it stands as a tool of division and separation in our homes? Such is secrecy. Any family that keeps secret from one another is divided. Taken from an example of women in abroad, also known as diaspora, that have assets, buildings, lands, properties without their husbands knowing it. And also men that goes behind the backs of their wives to do many things, investments, properties, to buy things above the knowledge of their wives. Such is called secrecy. Let me ask you, if you do not want your spouse to know about what you are doing, who is qualified to know about it? If the person you share the same house with, the person you share the same room with, is not qualified to know about what you do, what you own, or your future plans, why are you still married? Many people are in marriage, but they are separated. What are the remedy? The remedy is trace back from where that spot you stopped being open to your spouse. Trace back to that particular point where secrecy began. Start from there again and become more open than you expected. And you will see that it will begin to work again. Number two, reasons why couples are divided. Number two things that pulls down a home is lack of truthfulness. Any couple that is not truthful to the other is bound to fall. Any home that is not truthful to the other is bound to fall. We must avoid every form of lies. Lies destroys our marriage faster than cancer. And every trust that has been betrayed is very difficult to build back. So you must make sure that you uphold, you maintain your truth level in your home. Work together. That is the number three point. Couples that do not work together are divided spiritually and physically. If you refuse to work together as a couple, you are not fulfilling the order of God that says, "For this reason shall a man leave his father and his mother, and be clique and be joined to his wife, and they both shall become one flesh." Working together binds us together. Working together makes us grow in love and in understanding. Working together is a means or a channel of binding our marriage and our bond till death do us part. I want to draw the curtain of this program today here. Next time we will continue. Never forget that this is your program called Just Keep Holding On. And I remain your sister from another mother, Justina Obasokore, saying to you, a good marriage is that one what that is found on Christ and that is established in the Word of God. God bless you.